the chapter, The Rat Trap. Okay? Last day, I have completed up to page number 40, up to first para, I have completed. Let's recapitulate what we have learned in our previous class. So what we have done? We came to know that the daughter of the Iron Master, she persuaded the rat trap peddler and took him to their home, okay, to celebrate the Christmas. At first, the rat trap peddler denied several times. He refused several times, not only to the Iron Master, but also to his daughter. But what happened when the girl, the young lady, she approached towards the rat trap peddler in the forge, in the iron mill, and requested him to go with them to their house to celebrate Christmas. So after, when they reached their house, he was in a distressed condition. He was not well. He has a long beard. Even he was wearing rags. So he was in a bad condition. So the personal attendant of the young lady, he just made him clear, save him, and had given him a new dress of the Iron Master. So he cleaned himself with the help of that attendant and wore a new dress of the Iron Master. Then he came in front of the Iron Master. So as soon as he stood in front of the Iron Master, Iron Master realized that what mistake he had done. So he came up that the previous night, when the rat trap peddler reached the iron mill, from the glow of the light of the furnace, he mistook him as his old fellow friend. But in broad daylight, when this strange man cleaned himself and wore a new dress and came in front of him, in broad daylight, he could understand, he could realize from his appearance that this strange man, he actually was a stranger. He was not his old acquainted friend. After that, the Iron Master wanted to call the police, wanted to call the sheriff. Sheriff, I have said, sheriff is the chief executive officer of England. So after that, the peddler got very angry and he struck his hand on the table and warned him not to call the police. Why? Because he warned him and explained that this world is just like a rat trap. Now, if the Iron Master called the police, then this man, this strange man, or you can say this rat trap peddler, would be in a trap. The rat trap peddler warned the Iron Master that if he would call the police, then one day what would happen? This Iron Master would also get tempted or attracted by any good thing. Then he would also be attracted by this and he would also fall in a trap. So this we have done in our previous class, And now I'm going to start from page number 40 from second para. Okay? The iron master began to laugh. Why? Why he started to laugh? Because he did not like the idea that the peddler had given to him. What was that idea? That this world is nothing just like a rat trap. It seems to be a rat trap. If once anybody would get attracted, anybody would get tempted with or by a very good thing, then obviously he would get trapped and would lead to his own disaster. So he did not like the peddler's word. That was not so badly said, my good fellow. Perhaps we should let the Sharif alone on Christmas Eve, but now get out of here as fast as you can. So after hearing this, he decided that not to call the police. He asked the peddler to leave at once. He would not call the police, but what the peddler had to do? The peddler had to leave their house. But just as the man was opening the door, the daughter said, "I think he ought to stay with us today. I don't want him to go." And with that, she went and closed the door. So as soon as the iron master ordered the rat trap peddler to go out of their house, then the rat trap peddler approached towards the door, opened the door to move out. But what happened? The daughter came and she said that he must or he should stay with them for that day. Why? Because she had invited him as a guest for their Christmas. "I don't want him to go." And she also explained that she did not want that the rat trap peddler should go away. And with that, she went and closed the door. She defended and she requested the peddler not to go even and just closed the door. "What in the world are you doing?" said the father. So to this answer, to this reply, the father remarked that, "What the hell are you doing?" Why? Because the father realized that he had done the mistake, and this man, he was nothing else but a strange person. The father did not like the idea that this man should stay in their house on Christmas. The daughter stood there quite embarrassed and hardly knew what to answer. That morning, she had felt so happy when she thought how homelike and Christmassy she was going to make things for the poor, hungry wretch. So the daughter, she was feeling quite ashamed and she did not have any words to say. That morning, she was feeling very happy. Why? Because she could make the peddler's day happy on the occasion of Christmas. Because she was going to make some good things for this peddler. Because this peddler was suffering from, or he was in a distressed condition, he was in a miserable condition. She could not get away from the idea all at once that was why she had interceded for the vagabond. She had intervened the order of her father. Why? Because she wanted that this vagabond, this tramp, this rat trap peddler should spend the Christmas with them. And she had decided to make good this for this stranger. "I am thinking of this stranger here," said the young girl. "He walks and walks the whole year long, and there is probably not a single place in the whole country where he is welcome and can feel at home. Wherever he returns, he is chased away. Always afraid of being arrested and cross-examined. I should like to have him enjoy a day of peace with us here, just one in the whole year. Now, this girl, Edla, the daughter of the Iron Master, felt sympathized, felt pity for this rat trap peddler, though he was a stranger. The young lady said that he had to roam, he had to wander here and there because he had no fixed shelter. He was a vagabond. And there is probably not a single place in the whole country where he is welcome and can feel at home. So everyone refused him. Nobody was kind enough for him. So every time he reached anywhere, he was refused, he was denied several times. So wherever he turns, he is chased away. Always he is afraid of being arrested and cross-examined. So every time, wherever he went, he was chased away, and every time he had a fear of being arrested and cross-examined. I should like to have him enjoy a day of peace with us here, just one day in the whole year. So the young lady expressed her feelings towards this stranger that as he was a vagabond, as he was a very poor fellow, he was in a miserable condition. Wherever he went, he was chased by, he was arrested several times. But this time, as he had arrived in their home, he should enjoy the day of peace with them. Just at least a one day in the whole year. So the young lady felt sympathized, felt compassionate for this, that trap peddler. The Iron Master mumbled something in his beard. Mumble means speaking or whispering something. He could not bring himself to oppose her. So the father was not able to find any words to defend his daughter. It was all a mistake, of course, she continued. But anyway, I don't think we ought to chase away a human being whom we have asked to come here and to whom we have promised Christmas cheer. So the young lady replied to her father that though it was a mistake by her father, what was the mistake? That he mistook this stranger as his old fellow soldier. But as he had reached to their house and they have welcomed him, for several times they have invited him, but you have learned that he refused several times. He did not want to come to this house. Why? Because he knew that he was not that person. He himself knew this. And if he would go, he would come to this place, he would be in a trap. He would be in a snare. So this young lady wanted that he must, or this vagabond, this tramp, should get the happiness with their family while celebrating Christmas in their house. You do preach worse than a person. Person means a church priest is called person, said the Iron Master. I only hope you won't have to regret this. So the Iron Master said that this, whatever the girl was saying, the daughter was saying, it was worse than a church priest. And even if she had welcomed this rat trap peddler and allowed him to stay inside the house, it might happen that it would bring any adverse effect in their life. The young girl took the stranger by the hand and led him up to the table. sit down and eat, she said, for sick was she that her father had given in. This means her father had consented to her words. The man with the rat trap said not a word. He didn't speak out a single word. He only sat down and helped himself to the food. So he sat on the table, the chair, the dining table, and started to eat. Time after time, he looked at the young girl who had interceded for him. Why had she done it? What could the crazy idea be? So this rat-trap peddler, when he was eating, he was doubtful enough about this young girl, about this young lady, about her intention, that why she had allowed him to stay in their house. And he was wondering why she stopped him. After that, Christmas Eve at Ramzo's passed, just as it always had. The stranger did not cause any trouble because he did nothing but sleep. So the stranger did not cause any harm to anyone because he did nothing but sleep. He went to sleep. The whole forenoon he lay on the sofa. So he was laying down on the sofa in one of the guest room and slept at one stretch. So he was sleeping soundly. At noon they woke him up so that he could have his share of the good Christmas fare. So in the afternoon, after having the lunch, he went to sleep again. It seemed as though for many years he had not been able to sleep as quietly and safely as here at Ramzo. So it was like this, that as if he had never got the chance to sleep as he had got at this place. In the evening, when the Christmas tree was lighted, they woke him up. So as they had to light the Christmas tree in the evening, they woke him up, and he stood for a while in the drawing room. And he was standing there while in the drawing room, while everyone was busy, while enlightening the Christmas tree, blinking as though the candlelight hurt him. So if he was standing there, but he was getting disturbed by the bright light of the candle. But after that, he disappeared again. Then he again went to sleep. 2 hours later, he was aroused once more. So finally, they called him again. He then had to go down into the dining room and eat the Christmas feast and porridge. Up to page number 41, up to third para. I have completed up to this. If you are having any queries, any question, any doubts, please ask. I will reply now. Anyone? What? Meaning of sheriff. Okay. Sheriff means the executive officer of England. Okay. And we call them police, cops. In England, we call them sheriff. Next. Any other question? Any other question? Any doubts? Any other questions? If you are having, please do share it. Okay. Others, if you are having any doubts, please do share it and comment it in the box. I'll reply. Interceded means intervened, to stop. Interceded means intervened. Intervened or stop. Okay. Any other question? Any other question? Please do read the chapter at home. Others? Christmas fish and porridge. Porridge, you know what we call it. If we just cook semolina with milk, that is porridge. Okay. If you know what is the meaning of semolina, if we just mixed up some cook semolina with milk, this is called porridge. Okay. In Bengali, you can say it's one type of paesh. Okay, porridge means like that, or you can say rice pudding. Any other doubts?